Professor. I'm afraid we've lost the sonotrone, but at least Vulcan didn't get it.
Well, we can build another.
I guess Durkin's still puzzling out who Rocket Man can be.
We're dealing with a more cunning brain than Durkin's, Professor Millard.
It's that cunning brain that's forcing me to hide out in this cave.
If we could only find some weak spot in Dr. Vulcan's armor, some effective way of blocking his schemes and drawing him out into the open.
What if we publicly announced having created the decimator? You know, using it as bait for a trap.
That might work. Vulcan would be bound to try to get it. But we'll have to wait till the machine's finished.
It is finished.
You mean the decimator actually operates without an X-20 relay tube?
On a small scale. First, I thought the thromium waves would escape through the condenser. Actually, I discovered they could be transmitted at reduced strength through a coil resistor.
With what results?
Watch this. Know what this is?
I'd say it's manganese steel.
Right. One of the strongest metals known. Now just wait a minute. What's that steel bar? That sound is the high-frequency thromium waves radiating through the coil resistor. What's happened to your manganese steel, Jeff? Surprising, isn't it?
It's not only surprising, Professor, but in the hands of the wrong people, it could be terrifying. Now I have a little surprise for you. I've completed work on the X-20 tube.
Jeff, do you realize what this means? We'll possess the most potent weapon of its kind in existence. Can you bring me the tube tomorrow morning?
Well, I don't know about tomorrow. Vulcan must have figured out that I know Rocket Man. Every move I make may be watched. It might not be wise for me to come here again for a few days.
It's bad enough being cooped up here. To have to stay underground like a mole unable to work, Jeff,
I understand, Professor. Well, I guess the time has come to take Bert and Glenda into our confidence.
Jeff King to Millard. Come in, Professor Millard.
This is Millard.
I'm being followed just as we figured might happen. I'm leading whoever it is out into the backcountry on a nice, long, wild goose chase.
What about Bert and Glenda?
They're on their way to the cave in Bert's car. They have the relay tube with them. I gave full instructions for finding him.
Splendid. I'll install the X-20 tube in the decimator as soon as they arrive.
Right. See you later.
Hello, Durkin. Hello, Durkin. Durkin speaking. Jeff King's playing decoy. I just listened in on a radio communication between him and the late Professor Millard.
Millard? But he's dead.
He's very much alive. What's more important, he may be Rocket Man.
Sure. Sure he is. Where's he hiding?
In a cave. Now listen carefully. He's perfected a weapon he once discussed at Science Associates. It's known as a decimator.
What do you want us to do?
Bring Millard and the decimator to me. My directional locator indicates that the cave is in the neighborhood of Hermit Mountain.
We'll find him. Swing around.
out.
All right, Dean.
Hold him here. I'll pick up a couple of the boys and head for Millard's cave.
I hardly realize you're actually alive, Professor Millard.
I have our friend Jeff King to thank for that. Ah, the X-22. Now we can really put the decimator to a test.
Might be a long wait, pal. Better take the load off your feet.
Yeah. Think I will.
There. With the addition of the X-22, I believe this is one of the most deadly machines ever devised.
Calling Professor Millard. Come in, Millard. Calling Professor Millard, this is Jeff King.
I'll get it.
Don't bother. I'll get it.
Can you hear me, Professor? What's wrong?
King's broken free. We've got to work fast. Tie up those two.
Sit down.
Over here. To visit Dr. Vulcan.
Glenda, they're tied up at the cave.
Rocket Man, where's Professor Millard?
He's all right, but the tunnel is filling with lava.
Hurry, Rocket Man.